Introducing Chia Offers. Offers allow for the trustless peer-to-peer exchange of assets on Chia's ecosystem. What does this mean in practical terms? Well, if you have any XCH or cats or NFTs or really anything else that runs on Chia's blockchain, you can now exchange any of those assets with anyone who is running a Chia wallet, and you don't need to go through a centralized exchange to do so. Let's take a look at how this might work. Here I have two computers installed side by side, and they're both running Chia wallets. On the left, we have a computer representing Alice, and on the right, we have a computer representing Bob. Now, let's say Alice is a farmer. She has a small farm, she's been farming to a pool, and her pool has just given her a payment of 0.1 XCH. Now, Alice is really happy to have received this money, but let's say she wants to trade it for a stablecoin. How would she do this? Well, before offers came around, she would have had to have gone to a centralized exchange, sent her money there, then traded it for a stablecoin. But now she no longer would have her money in a wallet that she controls. So she maybe would have sent the money back to her wallet. And this is a little bit cumbersome just to trade 0.1 XCH. And on top of that, she would have had potentially two transaction fees to pay. Well, now all of that goes away. Here's what she can do. She can go to Manage Offers and create an offer. And she needs to select which type of asset to trade. She wants to get rid of her XCH. She has 0.1 available. I'll enter 0.1. And what does she want to receive? Well, we're also announcing that Chia is partnering with Stably USD. USDS is now running on Chia's blockchain. This is the first stablecoin on Chia's blockchain. There probably will be more in the future. But so she selects Stably USD. She needs to enter how much money she wants to receive. She can enter whatever she wants, but maybe she figures she can get 10 Stably USD for her money. Now she clicks Save Offer, and this is going to create a file, an offer file, and I have a offers folder here. She can save the file wherever she wants. She can now send this file to a friend, she could email it. It's only a couple of kilobytes in size, so it's not too big. She could post it on social media if she wants, or really anywhere else to get the word out that she has made this offer. But we give a few default options in Chia's wallet to share the offer. She could also share it on OfferBin, which, to be clear, is a website that is not affiliated with Chia Network Inc. And OfferBin, what you can do there is post offers and view them and download them if you like what you see. She could also share her offer on Keybase, and pretty soon we'll have a Reddit option available. There are also some AMMs coming out, and by the time you see this video, this dialogue here might look a little bit different. Let's say for now she wants to post her offer on OfferBin. Okay, she'll just check the details to make sure it looks good. Looks good to me. She'll click share. And now it is posting to that website as we speak. Okay, and offer shared. Now, I could go look at it on OfferBin. She also gets a URL which contains her offer, and I'll just copy that. This she could tweet out if she wants, or just wait for someone to accept her offer. So what happens on the other end of the offer? Well, here we have Bob. Bob does not have any XCH. He does have 10 Stably USD. Look at that. What a coincidence. Bob, let's say Bob goes on OfferBin and starts searching for offers that he likes because he wants to buy some XCH. Okay, but just for this demo, I'm going to paste that link that I just copied. And OfferBin comes up with the offer that I just created. Right now it says duck, but this will be changed to USDS. By the time you see it, it probably will already say USDS. Let's say Bob likes this offer and he decides to download it. He needs to act quickly because this is on a first come, first served basis. So he clicks Save Offer, It's going to save it directly to his downloads folder. Okay, now he goes back to his Chia wallet, clicks manage offers, clicks view an offer, and select an offer file. So I'm going to select that file that I just downloaded for Bob, the offer file. Okay, and now he can see the details of the offer, and he's going to receive 0.1 XCH in exchange for 10 USDS. He likes that amount. He can enter a fee if he wants, but there's no need typically right now on Chia's blockchain. And he clicks accept offer. Okay, he's given one last chance to back out, and I'll just click accept. Now, let's go back to Bob's wallet. Bob. Okay, this offer is now going out to the blockchain. Before now, the offer was not on the blockchain at all. It was just the file that had been created, but now it's going out there. And Alice, before this, could have canceled the offer if she wanted, but now that Bob has accepted it, it's no longer possible. So Bob has 10 USDS leaving his wallet. Soon he will be getting 0.1, that's pending, but for now he has zero balance. How about Alice? Well, let's close this. Her offer is still pending. She goes back to her wallet, and look at this. The offer is going through already. Alice now, let's see, she has 10 USDS in her wallet, and Bob has 0.1 XCH. And before I go, I should mention, this was not a demonstration on the testnet. This I actually did on the mainnet of Chia. This was real money being swapped right before your eyes. Alice and Bob happened to be right next to each other because of this demo, but they could have been on opposite sides of the planet. They did not need to know each other. They did not need to trust each other. Bob was unable to change the terms of this offer, and in fact, if he or really anyone else had attempted to modify the offer file by even one byte, it would have been made invalid. The file itself did not contain Alice's private keys or any other information that could lead to a compromise. And on top of that, this offer went through on an entirely peer-to-peer basis with no central authorities needed whatsoever. All right, I hope you've enjoyed watching this video. For more information, you could go to chialisp.com. We have all of the technical details out there of how offers are made possible, and we also have a couple of tutorials to help you get started. There's actually a few features that I did not even get to in this video that are mentioned in the tutorials. Okay, thanks for watching, everybody, and happy trading.